Good morning, everyone. My name is Mukta, and the title of my talk today is Nitrate Tolerance, a New Perspective. Now, imagine that something has blocked your kitchen sink pipes, leading to enormous water logging, putting pressure on the entire drainage system. A total mess, right? Well, angina pectoris, or heart attack, in common terms, is something similar. And the pipes that are blocked, in this case, are actually the blood vessels that supply blood and nutrients to our heart. One person out of every two suffers from cardiovascular-related complications throughout their life, a huge number globally, and a scary one too. Well, what can we do to treat it? One approach is we can take medicines such as nitroglycerin that actually increases the diameter of blood vessel so that more amount of blood reaches heart. Heart attacks can be kept well under control if the patients continue to administer nitroglycerin over a chronic period of time. But this all sounds too simple to be true. So where's the catch? Well, nitroglycerin itself can create trouble if administered for a chronic period. The blood vessels stop responding to this drug and we don't see enough dilation. So this condition of reduced responsiveness to nitroglycerin is clinically defined as nitrate tolerance. And the bad part is we cannot get rid of nitrate tolerance as long as therapy with nitroglycerin is continued, but we can certainly manage it. And past several decades of research has shown us why tolerance develops and how it develops, but we still lack a clear-cut understanding as to what exactly happens in these blood vessels upon tolerance development. And this is where my research comes in, because this is exactly what I'm trying to find out. Using an animal model of nitrate tolerance, I'm comparing control and nitrate tolerant blood vessels in order to identify some important changes in their function at cellular and molecular level. So far, we have observed that nitrate tolerant blood vessels do behave differently when they respond to nitroglycerin and other chemical mediators in our body that control diameter of blood vessels. We have also identified a key molecular change, that is a protein known BK channel, which is expressed in higher amounts in tolerant blood vessels. So what is the significance of all this, you may ask? Well, the significance is, for the first time we know what exactly happens in nitrate tolerant blood vessels. And we can certainly use this knowledge to keep nitroglycerin active for a prolonged period. And trust me, this is what millions of patients with heart disease today need, a new hope with nitroglycerin. Thank you.